There's earnings stuff, a number of them very good, rising COVID cases and lockdowns around the world, an election in a few days. What are you focused most on right now?
Well, I'm trying to focus on earnings. The biggest disappointment so far has been the reaction to earnings, right? I mean, it's nice to see that at least today we're seeing some reactions or some follow through to some things that got a little bit oversold. I mean, so far we've had 50% of the companies report earnings, and we've had 82% of them have actually beaten on the bottom line, 76% on the top line. I mean, these are really great, great results. And Guide's the best in 12 years, forward Guide. So all these things, and then you have these stocks that are down on this stuff. So to me, that's why they call earnings season silly season. That's why I always have cash on hand, and I buy on the kind of silly moves, if you will. So like yesterday, UPS down 8%. That's crazy. NXPI, they actually beat and raised their pre-announcement from just last week. So, and it was flat. So I actually bought that. Raytheon, you could say there are some issues there, but their free cash flow of $1 billion beat versus expectations, the stock's down 16% in 4 days. So these are the kinds of things that I'm focused on right now. Certainly, I don't think we're out of the woods by any means because of what you just mentioned, COVID, elections, fiscal, we've talked about all of that. But at the same time, if earnings can continue to come through, it's encouraging, and let's watch the reactions. And oh, by the way, economic data continues to recover.
Yeah, including claims data today. Another major chip deal announced as well today that we should mention, Marvell Technology announcing it will buy the ticker IPHI. It's an $8 billion cash and stock deal. Shares of Marvell are lower today while the other stock is surging. It's up 27%. Second deal in the semi space this week after AMD announced it was acquiring Xilinx on Tuesday. Marvell CEO Matt Murphy weighing in earlier on CNBC.
As we've seen, as recently as this week and certainly this year, you know, M&A in semiconductors has been robust. And one of the reasons for that, it's not the only reason, is that there's a huge benefit, Julia, in scale. Not only in scale in terms of manufacturing and cost, but also scale in terms of product portfolio and offering. And the types of accounts that we do business with, these would be the large hyperscale accounts.
Mike, such an exciting time for semis because of deals. And he described the environment pretty well. Where else are investors looking for the next one?
Well, I don't know about exactly where in terms of what companies are in play, except that what you're seeing is that larger companies that are on a roll, they have relatively rich valuations. They want to round out their kind of product offering. And this is a perfect little kind of fill-in product set that Marvell is acquiring. I believe Inphi is how you say it, even though it's surprising this is an $8 or $10 billion company. It does follow along what happens when you have, you know, this very long-term growth pattern in this industry that the market has recognized. And now on the reflex, the market hasn't rewarded the buyers. Marvell down a little bit. AMD was down a little bit on the announcement, but has actually recovered since. So I think in general, it's very much accepted by the street that this is a decent strategy.
Steph, where do you stand on this sector now? Are there any of the underperformers that you want to get back into?
Well, I am overweight in semiconductors, and I just mentioned NXPI is one of them that I like a lot. Broadcom is another one that really has lagged, and you get a nice yield, and they're doing all kinds of things in terms of M&A. I do like AMD. I like the Xilinx deal. I think this deal is a great deal, and I can't believe that Marvell is down this much. This is a very smart management team, and they're buying a company that's growing 40% in the last 4 years, and they're all of a sudden going to have, as he mentioned, size and scale, and he was talking about the customers. They both share Amazon and Google as customers. Can you imagine they're going to have more product to sell into these two behemoths? So I think it's a home run. I might even look at Marvell.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.